From the world's largest gathering of octopi to a giant eyeball, here are 9 of the creepiest ocean discoveries. Before we begin, be sure to subscribe to They Will Kill You. Hit the like button and request any topics you'd like to learn about in the comments section below. Number 9. Octopus Nursery. Since octopi are known as solitary creatures, researchers were rather stunned when they found about 100 of them nesting together near Costa Rica. However, another discovery would soon eclipse that one. In 2018, marine biologists deployed a remotely operated vehicle with the goal of studying an underwater volcano called the Davidson Seamount. As they were steering the vehicle at a depth of around 10,000 feet off the coast of California, it stumbled upon a creepy sight. Between the volcano's cracks, there were numerous female octopi huddled together, guarding their eggs. About 1,000 Muusoctopus robustus were found in what is believed to be the world's largest deep-sea octopus garden. For those who find a mass of thousands of tentacles moving at the same time creepy, this is definitely a nightmare come true. The Davidson Seamount gathering was a remarkable find, but one that also posed several questions. Researchers couldn't really determine why the water appeared to shimmer around the creatures. One potential explanation for the shimmer is that heat was coming out of the cracks. This might also explain why the octopi chose the area for the incubation of their eggs. The only problem is that the Davidson Seamount is no longer active, which means that the source of the heat remains unknown. Number 8. Hole in the Earth. On the ocean floor after tectonic plates separate, a void is left behind. The mantle underneath the plates then rises up and melts to fill that void. However, there's a gap in the earth that hasn't repaired itself, and scientists aren't sure how it happened. The hole is located between Cape Verde Islands and the Caribbean, about 3 miles below the surface. It's an area where the seafloor is normally about 4.5 miles thick. But upon examining the site, researchers found there was a lot of missing crust. In fact, an area of several thousand miles didn't exhibit the typical signs of the plate repairing itself. There was also serpentinite present, a rock which is formed as a result of contact between the mantle and seawater. Its presence indicated that the mantle didn't melt properly. What this might mean is that the rupture was so violent that it broke away a large section of crust. Number 7. Anchor Sister Twister. Found on the surface of a tropical brain coral in 2017, this microorganism is largely still a mystery. There is some indication that Anchora sister twister might belong to an early lineage of eukaryotic organisms. These are organisms with genetic material packed in a membrane-bound nucleus. However, so far, it seems this predatory microorganism isn't closely related to anything in the animal kingdom. Anchora sister twister is considered to be a protist, meaning that it isn't plant, fungus, or animal and doesn't belong to any clade. Protists are often grouped with eukaryotes for convenience. The only thing known about it is its creepy hunting technique. Anchora sister twister is a predatory flagellate that mainly feeds on other protists. It uses a whip-like flagella to propel itself while harpooning its prey. Number 6. Disappearance of the Atlantic Ocean. Even though there's no cause for concern in the near future, researchers have recently discovered that one day the Atlantic Ocean might disappear entirely. This is due to a subduction zone 120 miles off the coast of Portugal. Subduction zones happen as a result of plates constantly pushing against each other, which usually results in lighter plates melting back into the mantle. The Eurasian plate containing Europe and a part of Asia is fracturing. This means that at some point in the future, millions of years from now, two new Eurasian plates will consume each other, pulling Europe and North America together in the process. The result of the continental merge will likely include mountain range comparable to the Himalayas and the disappearance of the Atlantic Ocean. Number 5. Dead zones. Dead zones are exactly as terrifying as they sound. They can occur naturally, or they can be caused by excessive nutrient pollution resulting from human activities. Nitrogen and phosphorus are among the most common nutrients, and their presence can create algal blooms, which are an increase in density of certain types of algae. Once the bloom dies off, The bacterial degradation of its mass consumes the oxygen in the water, resulting in a state of hypoxia. The oxygen-deprived habitat can have as little as only 2 oxygen particles for every 1 million particles. Creatures like fish, which are able to swim quickly, will leave the area, but not all life forms in the oceans are fast-moving. Corals, starfish, or sea urchins usually die out as a result of the algal bloom degradation. This means that areas of the ocean floor that were once beaming with life become barren. An even more worrying aspect is that, in recent years, the number of reported dead zones seems to be increasing. Number 4. Carnivorous sea sponge. Chondrocladia lyra, also known as the harp sponge, was discovered in 2012 off the coast of California at a depth of around 10,000 feet. The interesting thing about this sea sponge is the way it obtains its nutrients. Most sponges are suspension feeders, meaning they filter microscopic organisms and bacteria from the surrounding environment. Much like its common name would suggest, the structure of Chondrocladia lyra resembles a harp. Once the sponge anchors itself to the seafloor, it uses its Velcro-like hooks and spines to trap passing prey, which may include copepods and other crustaceans. The sponge then secretes a digestive membrane which breaks down prey until it can absorb it through its pores. The recent discovery of the carnivorous Chondrocladia lyra sponge serves as a reminder that there are still so many remarkable creatures in the ocean to be found. Number 3. Creepy glass garden. While a submersible was investigating the Marion Trough in 2015, it discovered what so far is the deepest volcano on Earth. At 14,700 feet below the surface, they found a site unlike they expected. Intertwined blackened lava tendrils had formed something that scientists described as a garden of glass, straight out of a nightmare. The twists and turns covered a trench that was about 4.5 miles long. When the underwater volcano erupted, the lava rapidly cooled into a glassy substance, thus creating the creepy black tendrils. The sight wasn't stunning just from a visual perspective. The eruption was only a few months old, which meant it could provide bountiful scientific knowledge. By examining the site, researchers could learn more about volcanic eruptions on land, as well as better understand how the ocean's chemistry was affected by volcanic eruptions. Number 2. White Shark Cafe. Those who are terrified by the movie Jaws might want to steer clear of this area. There's a place in the Pacific Ocean at the midpoint between Hawaii and the coast of California known as the White Shark Cafe. After leaving the coast of California, an area that's rich with prey, the northeastern Pacific great whites would gather in large numbers in a single spot. The puzzling aspect is that, according to the images collected via satellite, the area was barren. Yet the sharks gathered in droves and stayed for the winter and spring. In 2018, scientists followed the great whites and tagged a few of them in order to understand why they found the location so appealing. When the researchers arrived at the White Shark Cafe, they found that it was actually teeming with fish, phytoplankton, squid, and jellyfish. While the reasons behind the gathering were much clearer, other mysteries emerged. The shark's prey would make daily trips up and down from the depths. According to tagged sharks, the predators did the same, hunting as deep as 1,500 feet during the day and at about 650 feet at night. In April, male sharks would make as many as 140 dives per day. What puzzled biologists was the fact that the dramatic increase in activity was displayed by only one gender. Number 1. Giant eyeball. The Florida Fish and Wildlife Conservation Committee had to deal with a mysterious find in October 2012. Local man Gino Covacci found a giant eyeball that washed up on Pompano Beach. Covacci decided to take it home, where he put it in the freezer. Afterwards, Covacci notified the local police, who referred it to the appropriate authorities. A little larger than a softball, the eyeball looked like it belonged to a massive marine creature. The tissue around the eyeball exhibited clean, straight cuts, meaning that it most likely had been separated from the rest of the body with a tool. According to Covacci, it was very, very fresh. It was still bleeding when I put it in the plastic bag. One exciting possibility was that the large blue eyeball was proof of the existence of an unidentified marine monster. However, experts arrived at a more tempered conclusion. The eyeball probably belonged to a deep sea squid or, even more likely, a large swordfish. The eyes of the swordfish appear smaller than they actually are because they're mostly hidden inside the head. The specimen that the eyeball belonged to could have weighed close to 1,400 pounds. Thanks for watching. Which do you think was the creepiest ocean discovery? Let us know in the comments section below.